So see question number 19 from here. It's very simple. Like discuss current number they are asking an electrolytic cell. So in an electrolytic cell, it is very simple. We have the anode and cathode. Now the anode is plus charge. Cathode is minus charge. Electrolysis. In electrolysis, anode is positively charged, cathode is negatively charged. And anode is the substance which will oxidize, and cathode is the substance which will reduce. So here, the issue is, now here they are mentioning the positive charge, but this is not positive, it's negative. Here they are mentioning the negative charge, this is positive. Actually, it should be a structure two, second structure, that's very simple. Now here, anode is positive, this is positive. Cathode is negative, and this one is negative. So the correct answer here is answer number two. Answer number two is correct. Answer number two is correct. Question number 90. And then when we are moving to question number 20. Question number 20. Which of the following statements is correct regarding the reaction between carboxylic acid and alcohol to give an ester? So let's see the reaction. First of all, see the question. What are questions given for that? Question number 20. So let's move on to the reaction. Now this is carboxylic acid, CH3COOH. We can get the carboxylic acid, CH3COOH. This is the carboxylic acid. And then alcohol, it is CH3CH2OH. So when this reaction is taking place, from carboxylic acid, we know this OH is removed. And this alcohol hydrogen is removed in the presence of sulfuric. In the presence of sulfuric, water is liberated. And then you get the product. So from this, you get CH3CO or CH2CO plus water is the product. So from the carboxylic acid, which bond is cleaved? So from the carboxylic acid, it is clear that CO bond is cleaved. From the alcohol, this OH bond is cleaved. Alcohol wearing OH cleaved, carboxylic wearing CO cleaved. Likewise, you can understand the trend. And then in this reaction, if you are considering the mechanism of the reaction, it is clear that CH3CH2O minus, that part will be adding here as a nucleophile. CH3COOH, in there we had that OCH2CH3, so it's delta minus, and this is delta plus, and this is delta minus. The negative carbon will be attacking to this, and the bond will dissociate. So this will give electrons to this, and bond will dissociate. So it is a nucleophilic reaction. As this species is removed, and another species is attacked, there is a nucleophilic substitution. Nucleophilic substitution. So here, the first statement. Make the first statement again. The overall reaction is a nucleophilic addition of a carbonyl compound. So this is carbonyl. CO group එක තියෙන නිසා carbonyl කියලා කියන්න පුළුවන් but it is not a nucleophilic addition, it's nucleophilic substitution because you know OH is removed. OH එක අයින් වෙලා තමයි අලුත් groups attached වෙන්නේ but it's addition without removing the current groups. If the new groups are attached, that is addition. So here the second one is the answer. මේක second එක තමයි answer එක වෙන්නේ. We are discussing question number 20 here. In question number 20, it is a reaction while alcohol acts as a nucleophile. Which the alcohol acts as a nucleophile. Yes, alcohols that O minus, it acts as a nucleophile like this. So a nucleophile means a substance which is having lone pairs and then the negative charge. So when you consider the third species, third reaction, it is a reaction which occurs while cleavage of OH bond of the carboxylic acid. Carboxylic ke OH bond ke cleave ban wali. Man, OH bond ke nevi cleave ban. CO bond ke. CO bond ke break ban wali tamai OH ke cleave ban. So ekata api OH bond ekak cleave wenawa kiyala kiyanne. So OH bond cleavage means separation of O and H. So this CO bond is cleaved. So the third one is incorrect. And if you get the fourth answer, කියවන්නම් it is a reaction occurs with the cleavage of CO bond so in an alcohol the OH bond is cleaved not that CO bond that's intact and in the fifth one it is an acid base reaction this is a condensation reaction in an acid base reaction this part should be gaining H plus now this is a nucleophile this can act as a base it should gain H plus if this species is gaining H plus we can call this one as an acid base reaction But here it's a condensation reaction, so the answer number two is correct. Answer number two is correct. And then there is the next one is 22. Next one is 22. So when we are moving to question number 22 here, see this 21. Yes, 21. This reaction it is again energetic. And this reaction. Simply, they have given methanol is converted to CO plus H2. CO plus H2. Then this is 128 kilojoules. So 128 kilojoules means it is endothermic. It is endothermic plus. So when it is endothermic, you know the products are having higher energy compared to reactants. Products are energetically ready. That's what it is called endothermic. The heat is absorbed when one mole of CH3OH is decomposed is less than 128. They have given this one, so it is very important. Again, our methanol gana hala thiyena ne paper ke deweni part me methanol gana hala thiyene. Here you have CH3OH liquid, and here also you have CH3OH gas, liquid and gas, two states. Okay, so when you consider this reaction, we can identify. CH3OH liquid converted to CO gas plus 2H2 gas. 2H2 gas. CO gas plus 2H2 gas. That is delta H is 120 plus 128 kilojoules. Only. So endothermic. Endothermic means the energy of products is higher than the reactant. CO gas and 2H2. They are having high energy compared to CH3OH liquid. Okay. That's what they will absorb the heat and move. So they will absorb 128. So make a lot of make a static got a ready, and then they will absorb that amount and reach there. So the first statement, make it a lot of important. The heat absorbed when 1 mole of CH3OH gas is decomposed is less than 120. So this is liquid to CO and H2. So they have given CH3OH gas. When you consider the gaseous state, CH3OH liquid is converted to CO gas plus 2H2 gas. So you get CH3OH gas. It also can convert to this. Now this was 120. If you get this energy as X, we can find this value. Né? අපිට මේක හොයාගන්න පුළුවන් it's the same CO and this so liquid to gas also there's a certain value okay they haven't given that but when liquid is converted to gas y and this one is x so when gas to when it is converted directly delta H naught to gas to CO plus H2 actually this is the addition of y plus this is equal to 120 y plus delta H naught is equal to 120. So actually delta H naught is equal to 128 minus 1. That means when the gaseous state is converted to these two species, that enthalpy is lower than the this value. So you don't want to absorb 128 if you have the gaseous state. It is lower than that. So because of that, the first one, first answer is correct. The heat absorbed when 1 mole of CH3OH gas is decomposed is less than 128. Yes, it is less than 128. Second one, enthalpy of CO gas plus H2 higher than the enthalpy of methanol. Eka harine penawa. From the enthalpy level diagram, it can be explained. In the third one, abhi balamu third eka, 128 kilojoules heat is released when 1 mole of CO gas is formed. Yes, 1 mole of CO gas is formed. This one 128 released. It is not releasing. It is absorbing. plus means absorbed. So the third answer, it is incorrect. Third one is incorrect. Well, incorrect එක තමයි අපෙන් අහලා තියෙන්නේ. So because of that, the answer is the third one. So they are asking the incorrect statement here in question number 21. So it should be the third one. Should be the third one. And then the fourth one, 128 kilojoules is absorbed during the decomposition of 1 mole of reactant. So you can see 1 mole of reactant during the decomposition. So if you take it better that name, when 1 mole of reactant is converted to products, 128 is absorbed. Statement 4 is also correct. Then statement 5, 128 heat is absorbed when 32 grams of products are formed. So what is 32 grams of products? Get the mass of the products. Carbon monoxide 28, hydrogen 4. So then the addition of these two is 32. So then 32 grams of the products are formed. So then heat is absorbed. Like that. Remember, I'm making a way. Here, I'm making a way incorrect statement. The incorrect statement is when the third data. මොකද third එකේ දීලා තියෙනවා හැලිමලේසී heat is released කියලා. When it is plus heat is absorbed. So answer should be the third one 21. Then we are moving to 22. It's an inorganic question. Let's see question number 22 from here. This one. Okay. 22 එක පොඩක් බලන්න. Electron gain enthalpy of nitrogen is positive. Yes. කියලා දී electron gain enthalpy of nitrogen is positive. Nitrogen electron gain enthalpy එක positive. And the other elements that electron gain enthalpy is positive is beryllium, magnesium, and noble gases. They are also having the electron gain enthalpy as positive. And what is electron gain enthalpy? When a gaseous atom gains an electron, and when it is converted to negative species, that's electron gain enthalpy. Then dilution of bismuth chloride. Okay. Bismuth chloride with water, it forms BiOCl plus HCl. BiOCl plus HCl. So BiOCl is the corresponding white color precipitate. That is true. H2S gas can act as both oxidizing agent and reducing agent. It is also true. Very, very simple. H2S can oxidize to sulfur. H2S can oxidize to sulfur and H2S can reduce to H2. And then my 4-5 statements I'm going to go back for prashna akune. Here, effective nuclear charge felt by valence electron in helium is less than 2. And then aluminium is inert towards N2 gas even when heated to high temperature. At high temperature also aluminium is inert. Right. So from these two statements, actually the correct answer is 5 because they are asking the incorrect statement. But then I'm correct again. Anyway, incorrect again. The incorrect statement is 5. Aluminium inert. Okay. So my discussion now regarding this question. You should understand in your resource book they have mentioned aluminium will react with N2. Aluminium will react with N2 regarding question number 22 to form aluminium nitride Al3 plus N3 minus aluminium nitride ALN at high temperatures. It's available. You know what are the elements that react with nitrogen? Eh? Lithium and all group 2 elements are reactive. And group 2 elements are reactivity doing beryllium, magnesium. The reactivity is low. So low reactive elements react with nitrogen. So aluminium also a less reactive element compared to like sodium, potassium. Reactivity decreases across the period. So then aluminium is also possible. It will react with nitrogen to form aluminium nitride ALN. In your resource book, it's available in the inorganic session. Then the effective nuclear charge. In the resource book, effective nuclear charge means the charge which is fair to a valence shell electron. Now, if we get the effective nuclear charge of sodium, this effective nuclear charge is equal to group number. It's equal to group number. So sodium's group number is 1, effective nuclear charge is 1. How it happens? In the nucleus, when you get sodium, we have 281. This configuration. So in the first energy level, we have 2 electrons. In the second energy level, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have 8 electrons. In the third energy level, we have 1 electron. But in the nucleus, we have 11 protons. So those 11 protons will liberate or will release plus 11 charge. So the effective nuclear charge means the charge which is fair to and valence shell electron. Valence shell electron field charge effective nuclear charge. එතකොට මෙතනින් plus 11 release වෙනකොට මේවා cut වෙනවා and from this 11 electrons that charge is decreased so in order to calculate the effective nuclear charge we have the equation z minus s so z means the atomic number okay it is 11 s means shielding electrons or coelectrons so for sodium the coelectrons or the inner electrons is this one methylene 9 so 2 plus 8 that is 10 so 11 minus 10 that is 1 plus 1 effective nuclear charge valence shell then prashne oka neme meke dunne helium ඉතින් ඔයගොල්ලෝ රිසර්ච් බුක් එකේ මෙන්ෂන් කරලා තියෙනවා ඉලෙක්ට්‍රෝන්ස් එකකට වැඩි ඕනම එකකට අපිට ඇටම් එකකට ඉෆෙක්ටිව් නියුක්ලියර් චාර්ජ් එකක් ගන්න පුළුවන් හරි so when you consider is it inert or not which one now when you consider every species right every species now this is sodium is plus 1 and when you consider every species like helium In helium, hydrogen, helium, we have two electrons. So in two electron system, there's only one energy level. Nucleus, it's having plus two charge, and we have two electrons. So अभी क्या ने valence shell लेके electron एक एक टा field में ना charge है. The charge which is fell to and valence shell electron. Okay, valence shell electron है एक टा field में ना charge है. So then we can consider one valence shell electron here and get the charge feeding to that one so then in here is it effective is equal to z minus s so is it helium is 2 so you have two protons so you can discuss this effective nuclear charge for the systems which are having more than one electron so here you have two electrons so we can discuss the effect of effective nuclear charge for this electron by this even they are in the same level but for hydrogen is not we can't discuss an effective nuclear charge because there's only one electron okay plus one is fed to that electron and it is not cancelled by any other electrons but when there are two electrons when a positive charge is fed to those two electrons a one electron can cancel the effective nuclear charge of the other electron that's the situation okay so here the shielding as the shielding electrons we should take one So 2 minus 1 is 1, so it should be less than that. But plus 2 වලට වඩා අඩු වෙනවා කියලා ගන්න පුළුවන්. So because of that, in here, the effective nuclear charge felt by a valence electron of helium is less than 2. We can take the answer number 4 as correct. Effective nuclear charge. Fifth one, aluminium is inert towards N2 gas even when held to high temperature. Heated to high temperature. Now that is inert high temperature එකට heat කරන මේ අහලා තියෙන 22 වල now in that formation even when heated to high temperature yes effective nuclear charge of that one they're asking aluminium is inert towards N2 gas inert කියලා කියන්නේ ඉතින් හරි එතකොට අපිට මෙතන answer එක 21 එකට අපි answer එක මේක 4 එක හරි කියලා ගත්තා එතකොට 5th එක තමයි incorrect ගත්තේ 4 එකේ වැරද්දක් කිව්වේ නැහැ නේ මම ප්‍රශ්නයක් අහලා තිබෙන නිසා මේකයි මේ check කරේ the effective nuclear charge of helium is less than 2 the less than 2 කියන එක ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ අපිට answer එක ඒක හරි කියලා ගන්න පුළුවන් 4th statement is correct they're asking the incorrect one aluminium is inert towards N2 gas so eka thamai waradi hari aluminium inert kiyana eka thamai waradi mokada inert nevey mokada aluminium nitrogen ekak react wala aluminium nitrate hadena the aluminium nitrate hadena kota inert wenna ba okay it can't be inert when there's a certain reaction okay so inert kiyala kiyana eka etakota waradi innawa clear inert kiyala kiyana kota eka waradi inna one okay yes hari ओके मैं क्वेश्चन එක අහලා තිබෙන නිසා මම ඒක ඩිස්කස් කරා. එතකොට answer එක 5 වෙන්නේ. answer එක 5 වෙයි. ඔකේ. So ගණන් ඒවා ගේවා clear කරගන්නවා. Okay. So the next question පුතාලා බලන්න ඊළඟ question එක. Let's question number 23. Question number 23 it's a pH question very simple. අනිත් pH වලට වඩා මේක මාන ලේසියි. හිතක් ගාලා ටික බලමු මොකද අපිට මෙතනින් ඉස්සරහට calculations ටිකක් තියෙනවා. Okay. Concentration of HA is C and then they ask in the pH. Very simple. So we know HA is a weak acid. It dissociates to give H plus and A minus. H plus and A minus, question number 23. So the H3O plus concentration is equal to Ka into C square root. Make the H3O plus concentration. Here, we can multiply both sides by minus log 10. So then minus log 10 H plus is equal to anipathe minus log 10 Ka into C is half power. So then you can get that term minus log H plus means pH. And this side, what I've simplified karan on kalpana mein, me half ek issara hat gaya. So then minus log 10, api meka simplify karat half kiyana ekak metana ganna. Half log 10. Then this is simplified in the bracket. Let's keep like this. Get this half here and keep minus half in this place. And within the bracket, get log 10 KAC KA plus log 10 C. Okay. And when there's a multiplication, when we are separating it with the log term, we get the plus sign. Here. And then simplify with this. pH is equal to minus half log 10 Ka and then this one also multiplied, so minus half log 10 C, like this. So may equation taking an input. Then when we consider the final state, here we will be getting pH is equal to, we know minus log Ka means pKa. Minus log K over the pKa again, and there's a half, so you can write half pKa and then minus half log C. Then a plus one, minus again, multiply will miss, make a minus one. So the clearly the answer is first one. And let's see, answer the first one. Then 24. I make a good thing. When ask question, question number 24. So let's see question number 24 from there. So in question number 24, here the question that regarding hydrogen peroxide. The strength of hydrogen peroxide solution can be expressed as the volume of O2 produced at standard temperature and pressure. Example. Okay. Again, hydrogen peroxide strength ka dena puluwanlu. Yagen release wenna O2 ganna. Again, O2 liters 20ක් හැදෙනවා නම් hydrogen peroxide the strength is 20. They have given the equation. According to that equation, the definition is given. Definition ekak ganna ekath ek. For 20 liters. So let's get the equation. 2H2O2 aqueous is converted to 2H2O liquid plus O2 gas. So the amount of O2 gas released in liters will be the strength. Will be the strength of this. So make a strength ekak wenne yanne. Then apita kiyala thiyena meka KMnO4 react wenawa sulfuric medium eke. Etalin apin ahanawa the volume strength of X kiyala. The volume strength of this solution. X කියන solution එකේ hydrogen peroxide. Okay. හරි. දැන් මෙහෙම. Now when you consider this situation, in the first part they have given the definition. H2O2 20. 20 volume of H2O2 solution will produce 20 liters of H2O 20 liters of O2 gas at STP. So when amount of O2 gas released as 20, it is called 20H2O. Strength, volume strength is 20. Can you mention O2 as a volume maker? Volume. If it is 20, we say the strength is 20. Strength of H2O2 is 20. Don't mix up. H2O2, the strength is 20 when the volume of O2 is 20. Just think the volume of O2 in liters, And liters means cubic decimeters. It will be cubic decimeters. If it is 10, the strength of H2O2 is 10. It doesn't depend on this value. What is the amount released by O2? What is the amount of O2 in liters? This is called the strength. Okay, now we can write the equation. When it is treating with MnO4- in the presence of H2O2, if H plus, we have to balance the equation. So we know MnO4- is reduced to Mn2+. And H2O2 is oxidized to O2. Then when you get the difference here, it's plus 7, plus 2. Let's get the difference. Plus 7 and plus 2, it's 5. Then this oxygen, for 2 oxygens, it's minus 2. And for here, 2 oxygens, 0. Difference is 2. Then interchange the difference. 2 to here, and it's 1, 2. And this 1, 2. And 5 moves to here, it's 5 here, and it's 5. When you balance the equation, you can consider the total oxygens. 5 times 2, 10. And here, 4 times 2, 8. So we have 18 oxygens. Here, 10 oxygens. So we have to add 8 more oxygens to this side. Then how many hydrogens? 8 times 2, 16. But don't forget this hydrogen. We have 10 hydrogens here. So this should be 6H+. Now the equation is balanced. So let's get the number of moles of the concentration of H2O2. And KMnO4. In KMnO4, 1M KMnO4, endpoint is 25. So regarding MnO4, they have given 1M, it's 25 cubic centimeters. Regarding H2O2, they are asking 25 cubic centimeters they have taken. We don't know the concentration. So get the ratio between this. MnO4 minus to H2O2. So MnO4- is 2, H2O2 is 5, 2 is to 5. Then write the number of moles here. You know, moles means N equal to Cv. So 1 into 25, this one. And then H2O2, it is C into 25. Then when you simplify this, you can get the ratio between this. Cross multiply karana, this into this is equal to this. So 2 into C into 25 should be equal to 5 into 25. So 25 and 25 is cancelled. C is equal to 5 over 2. That is 2.5. So the concentration of H2O2 is 25. 2.5 m. So H2O2 2.5 m. Na oxygen kochara kena wada. That is 2.5 over 2. 2.5 over 2, which is 1.25. This is moles per cubic decimeter. Moles per cubic decimeter. And then what you should do, you have to get the amount of liters. Again, volume. So when you are getting the volume here, use the next column. Volume, you use the mole volume column. Volume and moles. So at STP, what we know? Regarding 1 mole of the species, the volume is 22.4. 1 mole can be 22.4. So we can check the mole sticker, oxygen mole sticker, 1.25. So there are 1.25, volume check the volume. So that is the value. Okay. So for 1.25. So then 1.25 should be multiplied by 22.4. 1.25 should be multiplied by 22.4. Then the answer is 28. That means you get 28 liters of oxygen. Oxygen value liters we see attacking. So if it is 20, the strength is 20. So then if it is 28, the strength is 28. Okay. But like oxygen liters we see attacking on. H2O2 is volume strength, 28.2. Yeah? So because of that, the answer is 4. The corresponding answer is 4. You know how many questions solve karagane, but I've balana hadapu vidhiya. Okay, so we are moving to the next question here. That is a KSP question. So see the question. Question number 25. Regarding manganese, we are discussing this question. Manganese, M kela dilati, ne? MOH twice. This is pairing the soluble water, soluble salt. Regarding that, they have given 25. Okay, it's very simple. We'll be discussing they are asking then අපෙන් අහලා තියෙන්නේ m වල නේ m2 plus concentration එක අහලා තියෙන්නේ so when you get the m2 plus concentration very simple they have given the pH value we can calculate pOH question number 25 we can calculate the pOH value pOH value එක අපිට calculate කරන්න පුළුවන් so pOH is equal to 14 minus 5 it's equal to 9 so when pOH is 9 the OH minus concentration it is 10 to the power minus 9 so then you can write the equation මෙතන ඊට පස්සේ අපිට equation එකේ යන්න පුළුවන් mOH twice dissociates to give m2 plus aqueous and 2OH minus aqueous and the Ksp value they have given 4 into 10 to the power minus 36 so Ksp is equal to m2 plus aqueous into OH minus aqueous into square so that will make a C minus X this one is X and here it's 2X okay and make a X aqua within a 2X well square and Ksp value will be 4 into 10 to the minus 36 so when you simplify this you'll be getting the X value here 4X cube is equal to 4 into 10 to the minus 36 and it's cancelled and then the X value it is 36 like a simplify will I know power of 1 over 3 it is 10 to the power minus X is equal to 2 into 4 OH minus concentration එක අපිට දුන්නානේ හරි දැන් පොඩි මිස්ටේක් එකක් වෙනවා now in this case we don't want to write this format මෙහෙම ලියන්න ඕනේ මොකද OH minus concentration අපි දන්න they have given the OH minus concentration 10 to the power minus 9 so 10 to the power minus 9 square so in this one 4 into 10 to the power minus 36 is equal to x into 10 to the power minus 18 so then this 18 and this one is cancelled so the x value is 4 into 10 to the power 36 minus 18 that's again 80 so ege tamai x wala concentration 4 into 10 to the minus 18 kiyanne ka apen ahala debe concentration idi e wage answer ekot meke ne hari 25 idi metana answers ida api gattata passe e wage answer ekak ganna situation ekak naha 1 into 10 to the minus 18 kiyala ekak thiyen the answer is 4 into 10 to the minus 18 the concentration of m2 plus the solubility of mOH twice the solubility means this x it's equal to this one the concentration of this solubility means this one in moles per cubic decimeter so for this question also either it can be should be all because the answers dekama dilata thiyenne ehemai me when you consider answer number 4 and this so for question number 25 the corresponding answer should be all for that part also because there's no proper answer that is 4 into 10 to the minus 18 and is 4 into 10 to the minus 18 means that 25 වලට chance එක මේ විදිහට ගියොත් all වෙන්න ඕනේ එහෙම නැත්නම් answer 3 4 වෙන්න ඕනේ 3 4 දෙකෙන් එකක් ඉන්න ඕනේ අම ගොඩක් වෙලාවට answer එක all වෙයි මොකද proper answer එකක් එකට දීලා නැහැ okay so then question number 26 this one check this answer which one of the following use the correct galvanic cell එකන discuss කරන්න දෙයක් නැහැ අපි මෙන්නම කියනවා so when you consider this galvanic cell it's very simple magnesium electrode and salt bridge we know salt bridge when we mention a salt bridge we use a double line එකක් use කරන්න ඕනේ salt bridge එකට and in the cell notation in the left side we have write anode anode is oxidized in the right side we have write the cathode cathode is reduced so magnesium to magnesium 2 plus බලන්න first answer එක තමයි මේකේ answer එක වෙන්නේ question number 26 so magnesium to magnesium 2 plus it's available then 1 moles per cubic decimeter then the right side you don't you have water there is solution containing magnesium standard hydrogen electrode so hydrogen electrode means HCl and H2 HCl and H2 so there's H plus signs so then you have write the reduction what is reduction H plus to H2 so you have write platinum like this so nothing to discuss with the others now in this format as there's a phase change we don't use a comma always phase change we have to mention with a simple line and then this double line is used there to explain the salt bridge so clearly the answer is the first one okay So we are moving to the next one. That's question number 26, KD. Okay. So read the question. We are going to discuss question number 27. So we are going to calculate the calculation. And we are going to talk about this. So when you consider question number 27, the procedure was used to carry out to determine the distribution coefficient KD of a monobasic organic acid. So when you consider monobasic organic acid, balamo, monobasic organic acid. So we can consider the distribution between the organic acid and the organic acid HA or sodium hydroxide. For an acid, there's always basicity. So the basicity is mono, that means one. Again, HCl is a monobasic acid. Acidic is also a monobasic acid. It can donate 1H+. Dibasic means it can release 2H+, H2S, H2SO4, dibasic. Tribasic, H3PO4, releasing 3H+, likewise. So the monobasic acid, let's get this one as HA, it distributes between the two layers. Yes, they have to distribute pen. So, when we have 50 cubic centimeters of 0.2 aqueous solution of acid, again, initially, you are having the acid in 50 cubic centimeters of water. 50 cubic centimeters of water, acid again, 0.2 aqueous solution. So, we have concentration of 0.2 m cube. Volume is 50. Then, vigorously mix with 10 cubic centimeters of dichloromethane, you are adding 10 cubic centimeters to this. So CH2Cl, 10 cubic centimeters, dichloromethane, that's the organic layer. And then the two layers were allowed to separate. Thereafter, dichloromethane layer in the bottom of the flask was drained off. So here you had dichloromethane, as it is having the highest density, it will come down 10 cubic centimeters. And water, here H2O, it is 50 cubic centimeters. And then you are separating the dichloromethane layer canopy. From the separation funnel, we can separate this layer. And then 10 cubic centimeters of 0.02 sodium hydroxide was required to neutralize the acid remaining in the aqueous layer. So that means after removing this part, you get the aqueous layer. So aqueous layer in 50 cubic centimeters of water, you have HA remaining. After the distribution, this is initial. Actually, this value is higher than the remaining value because from the initial value, some sort of HA will dissociate or move to the CH2Cl2 layer, and then some sort of HA will remain. And then you are titrating it with sodium hydroxide, and then the corresponding amount of sodium hydroxide required is 0.02 m, it's 10 cubic centimeters. So, from this, you can get the number of moles of HA remain. So the moles of HA is equivalent to moles of NaOH. So remaining HA moles we can calculate. From this you can calculate initial HA moles. So then what is the difference between that? Initial minus final. Okay. So we are discussing about a single layer. Water. So when we subtract the initial minus final, we will be getting the amount of HA which was transferred to CH2Cl2 will give a particular thing. Then actually we want to get the concentration. So let's write one expression, KD, they are asking the KD distribution coefficient between CH2Cl2 and both. So CH2Cl2 should be the numerator. CH2Cl2. And then HA between both, like this. So how to get the CH2Cl2 concentration? That is the amount of CH2Cl2 that sodium hydroxide required. So CH2Cl2 is the therefore the dichloromethane layer bottom of the flask was drained out. It was taken and neutralized the acid remaining in the aqueous layer. Now aqueous layer is acid only 10 cubic centimeters of 0.02 sodium hydroxide required to neutralize the acid remaining in the aqueous layer. So aqueous layer means this one, 50. Yeah. So then we can get the amount of acid remaining in the aqueous layer by the reaction. Okay. So initially you had aqueous layer this amount, 0.2 into 50 over 1000. Become initial ticker. Remaining ticker මෙතන දීලා තියෙනවා අපිටනේ. මේ තියෙන්නේ final amount එක දීලා තියෙනවා. So then you can calculate the final amount from this HA. එතකොට මෙතන in HA layer the remaining HA mass they have given from this you can calculate. That is 0.02 into 10, 0.02 into 10, that's the number of moles divided by the volume. So this is the number of moles of sodium hydroxide and it is equal to HA and divided by the corresponding volume. In HA, the volume is 50. And then when you subtract this initial HA moles from the final HA moles, you can get the difference which was transferred to CH2Cl. And then that is 0.2 into 50 minus this remaining one, 0.02 into 10. Okay. This was the transferred amount. Initially, whatever the tibba tikai, finally, whatever the tibba tikai, edike difference ekka. So, edike inne, CH2Cl2 will transfer. Then that one should be divided by the volume of CH2Cl2, that is 10. That is 10. And then when you simplify this expression, I will balance the 1000 use karene. Here divide by 1000, here divide by 1000, and here also divide by 1000. That will cancel. That's what we have not written, that 1000. Here also divide by 1000, here also divide by 1000. So then we can write the expression like this. When you simplify this answer, we will be getting 245. Okay. And easily simplify this, then the answer will be KD, it will be 245. Okay. සාමාන්‍ය ලේයර්ස් දෙක අතර ඩිස්ට්‍රිබියුෂන් එක තියෙනවා. Yeah. So then the answer is 245. That means answer number මෙතන answer number එක එන්නේ 27 answer number 5. Okay. Answer number 5. So try to do it well and then try to practice more and more questions related to this. Okay, questions are practice කරන්න ඕන. So then the next question here it is 28. A reaction of C2H4 with O2 convert into CO2 and H2. Very simple, they have given the rate. Rate is proportional to the stoichiometric ratio. So see the question. Rate is proportional to the stoichiometric ratio. Yes. Now, very simple question. The question number 28, a reaction එක දීලා තියෙනවා. The reaction එකෙන් අපිට answer එක ලියන්න පුළුවන්. 28, the reaction is C2H4 reacts with 3O2 and it is converted to 2CO2 plus 2H2. So they have given the rate of one species. So මෙතන rate එක දීලා තියෙනවා එක species එක කාගේද? X, C2H4 was X. For this species, the stoichiometric one, number one, X moles per cubic decimeter per second. So they have given the rate. So if you know the rate of this species, you can find out the rate of the other species because rate is proportional to the stoichiometric norm. So when one mole of this species is reacting, here three moles should be reacting. So then the rate is 3X. As it is reacting, we are writing the negative sign. And then carbon dioxide, as it is producing, it is 2x and here also 2x. So nothing to calculate more than that. So 28, answer number 5. 3x, 2x, 2x, answer number 5. Next one, 29. Gatthekam katakaran pulaan. Question number 29, it's a kinetic question. Question number 29, this one. Consider the following reaction in a rigid closed container at temperature T. So the rate of the reaction is double when the concentration M was double. So then we can understand in 29, we can write the rate expression for this. Let us make a rate expression. Here, what will be? M plus Q converted to R plus Z. So the rate expression can be written as K into M concentration into power of M Q into power of Q. But the power of M should be equal to 1, because we know the rate factor is equal to concentration factor times order. So when the concentration is double, the rate is also double. Concentration double, then rate ka double venu. So because of that, the order should be 1. Okay, we make a two valing increase venu, kota make a two valing increase venu, the order ka kiyak venu 1 venu, okay. So when the m value is 1, we can get this one as 1. A prashne hai. Then in the Q case, it depends on the situation. They are asking the rate constant of the reaction under these conditions. So here, under this condition, the concentration of M is 1 into 10 to the minus 5. 1 into 10 to the minus 5. The concentration of Q, that is 2M. So we know when we contrast these values, like here, like 1 rupees and 10,000 rupees. So when you contrast these values, here clearly this is larger compared to this. Because when the reactant species is having different concentrations and one species is having excess concentration compared to other, we can consider that species as constant with respect to others. The QVK concentration of constant kela ganna pulan, m ekak ekka ganna kota. Okay, constant kela because of this. Okay, so we can get Q as constant. As the concentration of Q is constant, we can apply body change ekak karna kota the concentration of M plus and Q, Q will not change easily because it's having excess amount. This thing here changing the concentration by 0.002. So which one will be changed in a significant manner? That M, ne? Because M will be changing its amount. It's having a very low amount. This thing we adding 0.003 to that amount. So the concentration of M will be changed and then the rate will be changed. But if you consider Q, that concentration will not be changed. Yeah. So in that manner, we can consider this Q as constant. So then we can remove this part from this. So then the rate expression we can write, rate is equal to K times M. And then you can calculate the rate constant from that, making calculate. The rate of the reaction is 5 into 10 to the power minus 4. The rate of 5 into 10 to the power minus 4 kila dila tiyanawa. And K into M. So the concentration of M is 1 into 10 to the minus 5. So then we can simplify this to get the answer. We can simplify the answer. After simplifying this and this, we get the K value as 50. Okay. K value as 50. So the answer should be the fourth one. Answer should be the fourth one. Okay. Then question number with an answer 4. Then moving to question number 30. Question number 30 here. It's very simple. I'm gonna discuss organics. So when there's carboxylic acid, when we're adding chlorine, we know what will happen. This is a meta reagent. So when you add chlorine, chlorine should be added to the meta portion. Meta portion is chlorine add when no. And when you consider the meta portion here. You can see this is the meta portion. Okay. And then lithium aluminium hydride water, we know carboxylic acid will be reduced to third floor to first floor. Okay. Carboxylic acid to aldehyde to alcohols. So then in the presence of lithium aluminium hydride, it will be reduced to this event. Chlorine will not be changed. So here the answer is 2. Very simple event. Got a place. Okay. So we are moving to the next question here, 31. In this question, it was very important. Make a product important regarding the resource book. I will be explaining. Now, in this question, the product answer Svena Svenone. 31, the accepted answer should be 5. Okay? Answer should be 5. And then sometimes there can be answer number 2 also. Okay? 2 and 5, they come when they but the most probably it should be 5. Among 3D block elements, scandium is not considered as a transition element. We know now. They are considering scandium as a transition element. So what are the transition elements? The elements that they are having a partially filled d electron configuration. Partially filled d electron configuration in their elemental state or in an ionic state. In the previous syllabus, that was in only in ionic state. So in the previous syllabus, scandium is not a transition element. But in this syllabus, in now syllabus, according to the resource book, scandium is a transition element. So scandium to copper, all elements are transition elements. Scandium is a transition when scandium element is ion. In the ion of scandium, it is not having a partially filled electron configuration. But in scandium element, there's a partially filled electron configuration because scandium is a transition element because of that. The radius of the atom scandium to copper decreases from left to right. And make a question. Scandium to copper, generally we know the radius decreases across the period. Generally, the radius decreases across the period. But now let's consider the resource book from here. Just wait. We are considering the resource book here. In your resource book, they have mentioned in inorganic resource book under D block. Radius again, yes. So the radius of the atom scandium to copper decreases. So scandium to copper, when you consider the covalent radius, this is the event. Okay, so 144 132 122 18 17 17, and then decrease vela 116 150 and then 50. Generally, it decreases. Okay. Scandium to nickel, decrease. Scandium to nickel, it decreases. But then copper, it's not again decreasing. From picometers, they have given it's 117 and then 125 even. If you are considering zinc. But metanangalatin scandium to copper, they have not asked the zinc part. So, scandium to copper, generally, we can get it as decrease. But it is not. Always correct because copper is highest. In some make a general statement after the hurricane again, but when you consider copper, that's a higher value. It's a higher value. Ekatama issue here when I'm good enough. So then, most of the times, I'm going to make a hurricane again. Pulam Kela general statement after the because of your value by heart. The Ekanisa, if you want to trend again, always it decreases killer value. Always kill him. So again, it's incorrect, correct, they come in, they can take a gun. Okay, so okay, the resource book is on the day, and then let's move to the paper again. So when you're moving to the paper here, 3D block elements, scandium is not considered as transition element, it's incorrect, it's considered as transition element. The radius, I'm going to make correct, kela gunna pull on kela, I will incorrect gunna pull on here. Then nickel is blue color. We know nickel amine complex is blue color. When you consider amine complexes, cobalt amine yellow brown color. Nickel amine blue color. Copper amine is blue color. The chromium amine complexes they have yellow color and purple color. So what amine complexes they have to D block chart to study. Whereas zinc amine colors, yes, zinc all complexes are colors. So that is true. BC. Then IUPC name of K2NiCl4 is dipotassium tetrachloronickelate. Actually, here this answer is incorrect regarding when there's two potassiums, we don't say dipotassium. Di kela kiyanne neha kohomath. Potassium kela vitharai kiyanne. When it is 3 or 4, we mention only potassium. Okay? Potassium kela vitharai. So when answer B and C correct, it should be 2. Okay? So either if we get B as incorrect, considering the most accurate form, the answer should be 5. Okay, answer should be 5. I think good enough accurate. If you get 31 value 5, it will be at time. But 31 value answer 25. They come again. Clear? Okay. So I explain the IUPC nomenclature of that. It about the couple. Now, when you consider potassium, that is K4, K2, NiCl4. So this like this. And these two should be moved here, and K plus with NiCl4 2 minus. And then the oxidation number of nickel we can calculate. So make up X here, chlorine has a minus 4 and this minus 2. So then you can put this minus 4 to this side, and there is minus 2 plus 4. Okay, minus 2 plus 4, it should be plus 2. Like this. So the oxidation number of nickel is plus 2. So how we write? We can start with this potassium. Then get potassium. And then when we are writing this, we write tetra fluoro. Then make a main. Chloro rule එකක් break කරලා තියෙන්නේ tetrachloride වෙනවා tetrachloride CHLORIDE chloride මේක nickel නෙමෙයි nickelate anion එකක් අපි ලියනකොට 8 කියලා දාලා ලියන okay that is Ni CKELAT nickelate and then you have write the oxidation number without keeping a space that is 2 so like this write the oxidation number this should be the correct answer for that one however answer is 5 or 2 5O2 ඉතින් අපි මාක් ස්කීම් එක රිලීස් කරනවා ඔයගොල්ලෝ ආයෙත් අර කන්සස් චෙක් කරලා බලන්න ඉතල කොහොමද කියලා ඒක just commenting in the mark scheme there will be giving answers but in the results in the paper marking process also the answers will be amended paper marking process එක ඉවරුනාම තමයි හරියම MCQ answers ටික බලන්න පුළුවන් එතකොට තමයි මෙන්න මේකටත් marks දෙනවා මේකටත් marks දෙනවා අනේ එහෙම කියලා finally අපිට තේරෙනවා mark scheme එකේ මුලින්ම MCQ answers print වෙලා එනවා ඒ ඉන්නේ professor ගේ answers clear Okay, so then we are moving to the next question here. 32. Which one is our correct regarding the molecule? If we make it to the molecule, we will make it to the molecule. We will make it to the lazy questions. Okay. Now, when you are drawing a certain molecule like this, we have to start with the carbon-carbon double bond. So there's a double bond. We can start with the double bond. So around the double bond, the bond mate is trigonal plane. CO. Anna hum ekak tiyena man etin start kara. COH is there. And then the other carbons, it is C. And then when there's a triple bond, it's linear. Like this. And then you get oxygen. It's also linear, 180. Then after passing this oxygen, the electron pair geometry around this oxygen should be tetrahedral. So then 1, 2, 3, 4. So then you get 2 electrons here and you get C there. So then for this carbon, we have 3 bonds like this. So as it is tetrahedral, they are not lying in same plane. Tetrahedral not lying in same plane. So let's get the statement A. Atoms labeled as PQRS lie on the same straight line. So what is PQRS? PQ. R S T U. So when you consider PQRS, they are not lying in the same straight line because you can see they are in different straight lines. Then atoms labeled as QRST lie on the same straight line. Yes, QRST is clear. The sp hybridization and they are lying in the same straight line. And C. Atoms labeled as RSTUV lie on the same plane. RSTU, that is V, that hydrogen. They are lying in the same plane from here because trigonal plane is geometry with 180 format. Same plane. Then D, atoms labeled as RSTU lie on the same straight line. RSTU, not straight line. My lines dekha apne me. Yeh mein ka apne padr dawe. So there is a same straight line kya na be. Yeah. So BC correct answer is 2. 32. BC correct answer is 2. Very simple. And we are moving to 33. QC question. In that QC question, and let's see, in that part, the reaction is given. Well, I'm going to put the reaction in the question. Now here, we can write the reaction into gas. Reacts with 3H2 gas and it is converted to 2NH3 gas. So for this reaction, if you can calculate the QC value by applying these amounts. So my amounts you apply to the QC value. We can obtain the QC value. So initial moles you have to apply. Using the initial moles, we calculate QC. Using initial partial pressures, we calculate Q. So then when you calculate QC, it is 0.4 squared over 0.01 into 0.1 into power of 3. So then the QC value will be 16 into 10 to power 3. But your KC value will be 2 into 10 to power 2. 2 into 10 to power 2. So it is clear QC is higher than KC. So I told that QC means the products. QC proportional to products here. So the QC for the value non products value. Initially products value. So if products is higher, what will happen? So the system is trying to decrease the products. In order to decrease the products will be converted towards the reactants, and then your reaction will be converted to backward direction. In some products, reactants will convert to the way. The value is statement A. 33, statement A. Now, in that case, 33, statement A with the Haryana. QC is higher than KC. Ammonia starts to produce N2 and H2, and then the system reaches equilibrium. Yes, ammonia produces N2 and H2 until the system reaches equilibrium. Okay, that's right. Statement A. Then statement B, N2 and H2 react to form ammonia, and then system reaches equilibrium. N2 and H2 reacts with ammonia. N2 and H2 reacts to form ammonia. This system will equilibrium. Always both reactions will take place. Reversible, but method very poor. Favorable when backward reaction. Question number 33. So answer should be 5. QC calculate KC compare. QC KC product very numb, products very equal. QC can products over reactors. General reaction caution. So products ready now, products take out of the regular principle again. So in order to decrease the product, it will move in the backward direction. Here, we are moving to the 34, question number 34 here, this one. So it is very simple. It's regarding the HBr HCl reaction with this 34. So when we are moving to question number 34, we can get the products. CH3, CH, CH3. And then it reacts with HCl. Make HCl like a reactant. So if you make HCl like a reactant, we get major and minor products. So how to get the major product? Always hydrogen is added to the carbon, which is having highest number of hydrogens. Markovnikov of flu. Double bond like carbon and then again, hydrogen varying in a carbon, the hydrogen set. There are the major set current method. This is the hydrogen product again. CH3, CH2, C plus, then you get CH3. And then towards this, Cl minus is attack. Cl minus make it attack. Then you get the major product like this. CH3, CH2, CCH3, CH3Cl. So what is this? It's a tertiary alkyl halide. Chlorine attached carbon is having 3 R groups. When you consider this reaction, the minor product, the hydrogen is attached to the carbon, which is having the highest number of hydrogens. CH3, CH, then CH, this CH3Cl. Then this will become plus. So this is a secondary carbocation. But maybe I think this is a tertiary carbocation. And from the minor product, Cl minus will attack to this, and you get the product as CH3, CH, CH3, 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 CL. And here, okay, chlorine will be attached. The major product is 2-chloro-2-methyl-butane. So get the IUPAC name of this. So when you get the IUPAC name, we get 4 carbons. Then number it 1, 2, 3, 4. We number can put a subgroup and lowest number can number can. So 2-methyl-2-chloro. And then 2-chloro-2-methyl. This is A. Then statement B, secondary carbon is formed as an intermediate of this reaction. Okay. Actually, as an intermediate of this reaction, if you consider the major reaction, tertiary carbohydrate is formed, not the secondary carbohydrate. But the thing is, if you consider the minor reaction, the secondary carbohydrate can be formed. Secondary carbohydrate has a problem. The secondary carbohydrate is formed as an intermediate in this reaction. If you consider the major product, you can consider it one as incorrect. But if you consider the minor product, you can consider it as correct. Then statement C, in one of the steps in this reaction, HCl bond is cleaved to give chlorine radical. Make a radical sadhana, make a free radical substitution mechanism. Yes. And then D, in one of the steps of the reaction, nucleophile reacts with carbocation. Maybe nucleophile reacts with carbocation. The second step. This is an electrophilic addition reaction. Electrophile is H+. Electrophilic addition, but the second reaction is nucleophile. So then you can get A and D correct, answer number 4. Otherwise, if you get B also as correct, it can be either 5 or 5 Haryana Pulan, if you consider the second step. Then you can get the answer correct, you can get 5 kera hit anna school. Here, take this away, you can get the answer correct, you can get the answer correct. Okay. So we are moving to the next question, question number 35. See, it's very simple. Medical harima lesi, kiyanna taram dewal ne apita mekema katha karanna puluwan. So when there is a negative deviation from Raoult's law, you know, negative deviation means vapor pressure is decreasing. Vapor pressure ekak adu wenaka thamai negative deviation kiyanne. Raoult hitenata wada vapor pressure ekak adu wenawa. Ai vapor pressure ekak adu wenne? When those liquids are moving to the vapor zone, they have high interactions. The liquids, okay, in the liquid zone, they have high interactions. So the amount of vapor that it produces will be lower than the ideal amounts. The Raoult hitana odada an amount ekak aduwen. Clear? So then here total vapor pressure of the mixture is less than the expected total vapor pressure should it behave as the ideal mixture. Ideal ekak odada vapor pressure ekak aduwen ekak thamai negative kiyanne. Vapor pressure gana hitala thama api negative kiyanne, boiling point gana hitala nemei. Okay, so when you consider the total vapor pressure, it decreases than the ideal amount. It's true. Heat is released. I mean, heat ekak release wenne, because when the interactions in the liquid zone is increasing, that becomes stabilized. Liquid zone eke me dena interactions walin ekala interactions wedi karaganna kota, higher the amount of interactions in the liquid zone, they will become stabilized. Always when they are becoming stabilized, they will release the heat. Stable වෙනකොට heat එක release වෙනවා. Clear? So A and B is correct. Number of molecules in the vapor phase in the mixture is greater than. නෑ. Mixture එකේ තියෙන vapor phase එකේ තියෙන molecules ටික greater නෙවෙයි lower වෙනවා. Clear? Lower වෙන්න ඕනේ. ඒක නිසා vapor zone එකේ molecules අඩු වෙනවා. Heat is absorbed. ඒක අනිත් පැත්තනේ. එකක් වැරදි. So AB correct. Answer number 1. AB correct. Answer number 1. Okay? So then the next question here, 36. Very simple. CFC, HCFC. So, make up it. We know this is from man and environment. In HCFC, there is hydrofluorocarbon. Hydrofluorocarbon means around carbon, you just have only hydrogen and fluorine. So, make up what it is. Hydrogen, fluorine, with that. Carbon, fluorine. Yeah. You don't have any chlorine. Fluorine, stick both tamai, you get free radicals. If you have fluorine, you get free radicals from chlorine. Chlorine sibbat tamai free radicals enne, and here the free radical formation like chlorine, it will not available. Okay, free radicals hadenne HCFC abalam first statement ekak 36 make answer ekak 5. Both classes of compound CFC and HCFC have the ability to produce chlorine free radicals in the upper atmosphere stratosphere. Eka hari HCFC kiyanne HCFC kiyanne deka patla ganne pa. HCFC hydrochlorofluorocarbon. එතකොට එතන ක්ලෝරින් තියෙනවා. දෙය ඒක හරි. ඒක නිසා free radicals හැදෙන්න පුළුවන්. Fluorofluorocarbon, chlorine is available. But both classes of compounds HFC, there's no chlorine free radicals, so it will not contribute to the ozone depletion. Here, all the three classes of compounds CFC, HCFC, HFC are strong greenhouse gases. When you consider this greenhouse effect, actually all these gases are having global warming potential, and then they are a greenhouse, they are acting as greenhouse gases. So in order to act as greenhouse gases, they should have ability to absorb IR radiation, and they should have a long last time period. And then all these classes of compounds, CFC, HCFC, HFC, contribute significantly to ozone depletion. No, HFC is not contributing. HFC will have chlorine free radicals, nothing is contributing. So then AC correct, 36, answer is 5. 36, answer is 5. Okay, all right, next one. It's 37. The noble gases of these compounds, when you consider noble gases, hypochlorous ion disproportionates rapidly in acidic solution. Hypochlorous means there is OCl minus. OCl minus. You know, OCl minus is disproportionating to chloride. Make a disproportionate penny chloride plus ClO3 minus. Cl minus plus ClO3 minus. This reaction is taking place in basic medium. This reaction is taking place in basic medium. Make a basic medium, make a acidic medium, make a venine. Because you know HOCl, it dissociates to H plus and OCl minus. In basic medium, this undergoes this reaction. Okay? Acidic keratin is I may 37 make a better. Xenon forms a series of compounds with fluorine. XeF4 has a square planar geometry. So, like a hurry, square planar geometry, 37 mela, like a head. XeF4 is square plane. Among hydrogen halides, HF has the highest bond length. You know, when we move downwards, HF, HCl, HBr, HI, the bond length increases. Radius very well is a bond length. So then the bond dissociation energy will decrease. Downwards a group. Right? HF will be the bond energy. The highest bond dissociation enthalpy is HF. The highest bond dissociation enthalpy will be available with HF. Boiling points of hydrogen halides increases downwards a group. Hydrogen halides mean halogens. Yes, boiling points will increase as the mass increases. Fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, likewise the mass is increasing. When the mass is increasing, you know, boiling points will increase. So then, statement BCD. 37 statements BCD correct. Answer is 5 again. Okay, 5 again. Very simple. Like I am going to discuss karan. Make it look that name. We could have discussed karan. When it's about the game. 38. And then, which of the following is correct regarding the Daniell cell when it operates at room temperature? Daniell cell means zinc, copper sulfate, copper. Okay, zinc sulfate, zinc, copper sulfate, copper. So we know in that reaction, in that Daniell cell reaction, 38, so first one, we can get zinc electrode with zinc sulfate, and then copper electrode in the presence of copper sulfate, and we can connect it like this using a voltmeter, and this will be the salt bridge. Actually, why we are adding a salt bridge? In order to keep the electron neutrality in the solution. In this terminal, positive charge can be increased. In this terminal, the negative charge can be increased. In order to avoid it, we add the salt bridge. So as the salt bridge, we use like potassium nitrate, ammonium chloride. So then the negative ions will migrate to this version. And then the positive charge will be decreased. And here, negative charge will increase. So the positive ions will migrate to there. And then the charge will decrease. It will keep the electron neutral. Here, so what is the possible reaction? This is anode. We know anode is undergoing oxidation. So, you know, when zinc is converted to zinc 2 plus, as it is releasing electrons, this electrode will get the negative charge. And then that terminal, it is cathode, it undergoes reduction. So then copper 2 plus will gain 2 electrons to get into copper. So then it will be positive. Okay? So negative to positive, that is electron flow. So with the first statement, net electron flow occurs from zinc to copper. Yes. That is from, that is correct, zinc 2 copper. Then statement B, the equilibrium zinc 2 plus to zinc shift to right. Can shift to right, can zinc 2 plus a zinc cannot. Then zinc a zinc 2 plus, you know, then a liquid junction potential is created. No. When we adding the salt bridge, liquid junction potential is, liquid junction potential is cancelled. Actually, the liquid junction potential means, when the two solvents kept like this in a single solution, zinc sulfate, copper sulfate. And here you have copper electrode, zinc electrode. There will be a charge difference between this. Charge difference ekak ena. Zinc to zinc plus, and then positive ions will migrate here. And here the negative ion. Between the layers, between the two solvent layers, there will be a charge separation. So that charge separation is known as the liquid junction potential. Liquid junction potential. So the main potential ekak tiyena kota, the actual value of this voltmeter will be decreased due to this potential. So then in order to avoid the liquid junction potential, we use the salt bridge. So when the salt bridge is there, this condition is removed. Cations and the anionic compound and so the anode and the cathode is separated. So then there won't be any liquid junction. So because of that, it is cancelled. Then when you consider statement D, the equivalent copper 2 plus 2 copper shift to right. Like I said, copper 2 plus 2 copper is right way. It can be copper 2 plus copper way. So A and D correct, answer is 4. Okay. So question number 38, answer is 4. And question number 39, we will discuss karamu. Ideal gases at constant temperature. So when you consider question number 39, this one, we know එකත් ඉතින් අර කියලා තියෙන තරම් කිසිම ප්‍රශ්න එකක් නැහැ ලේසි. අහලා තියෙන ලේසිම ප්‍රශ්න එක වගේ එක. Very simple. මේ when you consider the states at high pressures the volume of at high pressures the volume of the real gas is higher than that of ideal gas. We know at very low pressures and high temperatures real gas are behaving as ideal gas. So at very high pressures කියලා තියෙනවා 39 at very high pressures volume of a real gas is higher than that of ideal gas. So we know always the volume of a real gas is higher compared to the ideal gas, because ideal gas we assume it is acting as a point mass, and then this is correct. Then make a manipatta method is that at very high pressures the volume of a real gas is lower than kela, so then C is incorrect. 39 at high pressures real gas tend to behave as ideal gases. We know it is low pressures, at very low pressures and at very high temperatures, at low pressures real gas tend to behave as ideal gases. That is correct. So A and D correct, answer is the fourth one. A and D correct, answer is the fourth one. So we're moving to an explanation here, why it is happening like that. We know when you consider real gases, they have a certain volume, and then they are not acting as point masses, they are having interactions. But if you consider ideal condition, they are point masses, and then there are no interactions, point masses and no interactions. So at very low pressures, according to the Boyle's law, the volume will increase. Pressure ek adu wenakota mokada wenne, volume ek increase. So as the volume increases, this condition will change to a condition like this. They will apart from each other. So then when you consider this distance with this size, the diameter is negligible compared to this distance. That's what we say, at low pressures, as the volume increases, the real gases are behaving as ideal gases at low pressures. The distance will increase. And then the next thing is at high temperatures. So when you consider high temperatures, temperature value වෙනකොට මොකද වෙන්නේ? The kinetic energy will increase. So when the real gases are moving very fast, what will happen? The interactions will decrease. So then when the interactions will decrease, again you get the ideal condition. එනිසා අපි මතක තියාගන්න ඕනේ, real gases are behaving as ideal gases at very low pressures and at very high temperatures. So ඒක නිසා 39 the answer was fourth one. 39 වල answer ka 4 one. Okay, question number 40 here. Question number 40. Which of the following statements is correct regarding the industrial process? Okay, sodium. So api gattot the first two steps involved in the manufacture of sodium carbonate solvent process are endothermic. So actually what is the first statement? First step mulinma palawenima step ekak thamai. This way. at high pressures as the real gas volume is less than the ideal gas. Generally, real gases and ideal gases, when we consider at the same pressure, real gas is having a higher volume compared to the ideal gases. Because ideal gases are not, there's no gases called ideal gases, it's a certain situation. Now, the question ka kahan nisa, now ideal gas behavior is a certain behavior. There are no gases called ideal gases. So it is a hypothetical behavior. In that condition, we consider the mass is considerable, there's a mass, but the volume is negligible. So we consider the real gases to the ideal condition by changing the volume and by changing the pressure and temperature. So when a real gas is converted to the ideal condition, we have to decrease the pressure. When we decrease the pressure, the volume is increased. So as the volume is increased, the gap between the molecules will increase. So then the size of the molecule is comparatively negligible. But here, මෙතන මේ නිකන් ප්‍රශ්න එකක් අහන්නේ ideal වලද real වලද volume එක වැඩි කියන. එතකොට pressure එක decrease කරන එකක් ගන්න එපා. Just consider one single pressure and contrast real and ideal. When you contrast that thing, it is clear that real gases are having a volume compared to ideal, because always ideal behavior is defined as the state which it acts as a point mass. Then real, always there's a volume. O2, N2, CO2, helium, those gases are having a volume. So we consider the volume as negligible when we compare with the distance between two gas molecules. In order to increase the distance, we have to increase the volume. That's the thing. Comparatively, we are considering that. Ideal means it's a state. It's a state. Clear? Okay. So we are moving to the next question here. The first two steps involved in the manufacture of sodium carbonate solvay process are endothermic. We have discussed that. We have done the solvay process. First step we are treating ammonia with water. Ammonia with water. It converts to NH4+ and OH-. In the second step, OH- is reacting with CO2 and it is converted to bicarbonate ions. And then the formation of bicarbonate, this is exothermic. This one also exothermic. Abhi godak industrial wala dikhane exothermic reactions. With exothermic gattata passe apde ekak baasi ne heat ekak release wenawa. So in that exothermic process we get bicarbonate A10. Hari endothermic කියලා දීලා තියෙනේ endothermic දීලා තියෙන නිසා ඒක වැරදි වෙන්නේ question number 40 they have given endothermic then the presence of magnesium calcium sulfate in brine hinders the production of sodium hydroxide in the membrane cell method මේක resource book එකේ හරියට කියනවා if you have magnesium ions you can add carbonate in order to precipitate as magnesium carbonate before you obtain sodium hydroxide. If you have calcium, you can add carbonates. If you have sulfates, you can add barium chloride. Yeah. If you have sulfates, you can add barium chloride in order to precipitate as barium sulfate. First of all, you have removed this. Otherwise, it will change the production of sodium hydroxide process. It will intervene in that process. Yeah. So, see, the first step, taken is a hurry of it. The first step involved in the manufacture of nitric acid by Ostwald method is the oxidation of ammonia gas to O2 in the presence of catalyst to give NO2 gas. අන්න ඒක තමයි වැරදි. NO2 නෙවෙයි හැදෙන්නේ. NO. So the reaction එක ammonia plus O2, generally ammonia with O2 produces N2 plus H2O. But in nitric production we get NO plus H2O by adding the catalyst NO at 900 Celsius. මොකද NO2 දෙන නිසා ඒක වැරදි. Clear? Statement D, high temperatures and low pressure conditions are employed in the manufacture of ammonia gas using Haber process. So in Haber process, N2 and H2 react to form ammonia. So you know this is a reaction which is exothermic. Okay. And then to this way, when we balance this equation, 2, 2, and here 3 times 2, 6, the number of gas molecules will decrease. Gas molecules are doing okay, the pressure card will only. The pressure card will not up initially. We are using high pressure. ඒත් අපි කියන අපිට high pressure එකක් use කරන්න බෑ. ඒකට ලොකු cost එකක් යනවා කියලා. ඒක නිසා pressure එක විදිහට අපි 250 atm use කරනවා. And then temperature, as this is an exothermic reaction, we have to use low temperature. Okay? Low temperature is preferred. But ගොඩාක් temperature එක අඩු කරන්න නෑ rate එක අඩු වෙන නිසා. So then the optimum temperature is 450 Celsius. ඉතින් ඔය D වල මොකක්ද කියලා තියෙන්නේ? High temperature use කරනවා. නෑනේ. And then D වැරදි. ඉතින් ඒක නිසා B විතරයි හරි. Answer is 5. Question number 40. answer is 5. So we are moving to the last 10 questions from here. So then this is 41. Methanam research karana. Now when you consider the statement 41, oxides of chromium, manganese are acidic while CrO3, Mn2O are basic. Actually, the first statement that is incorrect. Higher oxidation states, now when you check the oxidation type of chromium is +6. Manganese is +7 here. Higher the oxidation state, higher the covalent character. So higher the covalent character means those are acidic. Then basic is the statement is incorrect. And then the acidic basic nature of the oxides of chromium and manganese depend on the oxidation number. Oh. Oxidation number vary, acidity vary, covalent character vary. Again, 41, the answer should be the fourth one. Acidic buffer solution can be prepared by mixing HA with NA. Yes, we know HA and NA, weak acid with its strong base. HA copy treat karana on sodium hydroxide. And then what happened to sodium acid. May then another buffer ekak kiyala. Meke pH value ekak depend wenawa Henderson equation ekken ganna puluwan. Clear? So it's correct. Me hari. When OH- minus and H+ ions are added to a buffer solution, the added amount of OH minus and H plus ions are removed through the reactants. So when you know, then I make explain it. OH minus is reacting with the amount of H plus. When I H plus there. So that H plus is reacting with OH minus and it is converted to A minus and H2. So this HA is acting as the agent for OH minus. And then when you add H plus will react with A minus from this sodium acetate. Sodium acid tamai godak A minus denne and that A minus will form HA respective. Actually that is also true. So when you get 42, both statements are true. Second one explains the first one. Answer is 1. Essential oils can be extracted from plants by steam distillation temperature below 100 Celsius. 43, actually that is correct because methanol essential oils, like we are mixing essential oil with water. So we know water, the boiling point of water is 100. But in steam distillation, we know always the boiling point of the mixture is lower than the two substances. Again, essential oil like water like then again boiling point or boiling point mixture boiling point. That is the technique called steam distillation. The total vapor pressure is equal to the addition of the saturated vapor pressure. So it is below 100 kNa high. But methana kNa at the temperature which the mixture of essential oil and water boils, even boil the total vapor pressure of the system is less than the atmospheric pressure. No, always when it is boiled, abhi dana boiling point ke lafi define karane, the total pressure, the total vapor pressure, let's consider PT, the total vapor pressure, it should be equal to the atmospheric pressure called the pi value. Atmospheric pressure ke total vapor pressure ke equal bena vena avatama abhi boiling point ke. Dine, mekanisa ek atava varadi, boil bena event te kedi, total pressure ka atmosphere pressure ka equal to n. Both pressures should be equal. So the first one is correct, the second one is incorrect. So answer is the third one. Okay. 43 answer is the third one. Then at a given temperature and pressure, the molar volume of the two different gases are different from each other. When you consider the make a epidemic, Avogadro's equation again kiya. Avogadro's law. At a given temperature and pressure, same. Within pressure is the same, temperature is the same. So when you consider the volumes of the two different ideal gases are different from each other. But a balloon maker, and then we can the statement 44. You have the equation again, you have the element for one. What is Avogadro's law? At constant pressure and temperature, equal volumes of different gases have the same number of molecules. Same number of molecules can occur again. There will be 44 can get done. When we write PV is equal to NRT instead of V, you know, capital N equal to simple N times L, N minority and Napoleon, N now equal to R. So, when 44 will the first statement again, at a given temperature and pressure, the molar volumes of two different gases are different from each other. So, when you consider volume, pressure is constant, temperature is constant. So then R and L, that's also a constant value. So then if we consider two different gases, they are different from each other. Okay? they are different from each other, actually that part is incorrect. They are the same, because at a given temperature and pressure, the molar volumes of two different gases are different from each other. You know, the regular different when in a same way, no? Because the number of molecules of the gases will not change. Number of molecules. As Na is equal to Nb, the molar volumes kela gattam. If we get the same volume, we know V is proportional to Na. If we get the second gas Nb, V is proportional to Nb. At the molar volume ekak wenas wenna ne. Volume of one mole. If the volume is constant, Na is equal to Nb. The number of gas molecules also same. At a given temperature and pressure, the molar volumes, volume of one mole, ekak den api dannawa 22.4 kiyalath ne. Ekena volume of one mole constant, the gas molecules wenas unata molar volumes wenas wenne ne. Are different from each other. So ekak waradi. First statement is incorrect. The second statement, ekak prashnayak naha ne. Mokak tiyene? At zero temperature and 1 atm pressure, when you consider molar volume, that is STP, standard temperature and pressure. So what is standard temperature? It is 0 Celsius or 273 Kelvin. And what is pressure? That is 180. Here, so there is a hurry. So then answer is 44. 44 will answer. Okay, when you 4 kN. And 45, all compounds having C-C bond show distereomer. So when you consider 45, carbon-carbon, it shows distereomer. Okay. 44, then you know, distereomer will be no kN. In order to show the distereomerism, there should be different groups attached. If they are having the same groups, they will not show the distereomerism. And in the second one, any two isomers which are not mirror images of each other are distereomers. Okay. Now, you know, in stereoisomers, that can be distereomers or enantiomers. So if those are not mirror images, they are not the enantiomers. Mirror images when nothing, enantiomers when anything. So then they will become distereomers. But hemavin is stereoisomers. Now just think, apart from this, you have isomers called structural isomers. Okay? Structural isomers like this, CH2CH, with this we can consider another isomer like CH3CH. So these are chain isomers. But there are chain isomers. When you consider an isomer type like this, now we make an item. All isomers, any two isomers which are not mirror images of each other are distereomers. So these are not mirror images of each other. These are isomers and they are not mirror images. But we can call these ones as distereomers. So because of that the second statement, okay, 45, the second statement also incorrect, answer is 5. But stereoisomers kila dila tibbana ek ganna tibba. Stereoisomers kila kila ne? Then stereoisomers kila tamai. Mirror images when in a time distereomers way. You know, the structural isomers will be able to get on mirror images when in a, but they are not distereomers. Mirror images when in a, the homo distereomers when in a. Yeah, so answer is 5. And then when we move to the next question, 46, hydrogenation of benzene is difficult than the hydrogenation of alkenes. So 46. Hydrogenation of benzene. So we know there's a stabilization in pi bonds. There are 6 pi electrons, and then when you add hydrogen, you get cyclohexane. This is an electrophilic addition reaction. Okay. You get structure again, but it is not a stable reaction for benzene, as the resonance stabilization is available with the electrophilic substitution. The make a favorite way. 47, the first one. The reaction 46, hydrogenation of benzene is more difficult than the hydrogenation of alkenes. Alkenes is easier. Okay. Alkenes are easy. Benzene ka tika amaru stabilization ka nisa you have to give high temperatures. Okay, so again it's a first statement ka hari. Then the second one, we can explain you know, addition of hydrogen to benzene results in a loss of aromatic stabilization. Yes, when you consider the stabilization, when you have the pi bonds, it's stabilized resonance hybrid. Okay, it can form the resonance hybrid and get the stabilization. But when you consider the cyclohexane, it is not resonance stabilized. So answer is 46. And 47, the reaction takes place between SO3 gas and water in the production of sulfuric acid is endothermic. endothermic. No. When you add any substance, SO3 to water. SO3 because water, SO3 generally reacts with water to form sulfuric. Okay. And then that reaction is an exothermic reaction. 47 SO3 with H2 produces H2SO4. It's highly exothermic. ගොඩක් exothermic එක නිසා පළවෙනි එක වැරදි. ඊට පස්සේ කියලා දෙනවා SO3 reacts with concentrated H2SO4 to give allele. That's correct. Second reaction, SO3 with H2SO4. It forms H2S2OSO. Okay. The second statement, that is correct. First is incorrect, second is correct. So 47, answer is 4. What is oleum? We get H2S2O7 and adding it to water to get sulfuric. Okay, it's a white color fume. Very stable. Water will add color from a react. There is an exothermic reaction. Sulfuric production again. Halati. Then 48, reaction between ammonia and alkyl halide gives primary, secondary, tertiary amines and quaternary ammonium salt. Now, if you have a conversion, you can see that. When you consider the 48, that part, CH3Cl. When you treat this one with an ammonia, CH3CH2NH2, these hydrogens can be removed and then this part can be attached. Yeah, chlorine and hydrogen is removed and this one is added. So this lone pair is always available. So you get CH3CH2NHCl first product. All right, make it. Let's see. Tawat H ka kain vela. You can consider this H is removed with Cl and you get CH this product, and then CH3CH2N, and this H is removed with this Cl. Again, the second one is attached. Yeah. That's a male on track of time in the full one. And you can get CH3CH2N, CH3CH3, again CH3, and this plus and Cl minus. This way. Make my quarter break here. Okay. This is my hemostatic and the full one. 48. So, because of that, the first statement it is correct. And the second one, okay, explain me now. Primary, secondary, tertiary amines can react as nucleophiles. So this is primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine. In all those ones, lone pair is available. So when the lone pair is available, they can react as nucleophiles. Answer is 1. 48, okay, answer, come on. 49, P plus Q gives R. First order reaction with respect to the reactant P. Now, when you consider 49, last two questions. 49 here. P plus Q converts to R. First order reaction with respect to reactant P. So when you write the rate law, rate is equal to K times P to the power 1 and Q. The graph of the rate against the concentration of P gives a straight line passing the origin. Yes. So we know if the concentration and rate graph, when the concentration is increased by 2 times, rate is also increased by 2 times, and then the graph is like this. So the order is 1. Order 1 වෙනකොට මෙහෙමයි. Order 0 වෙනකොට මෙහෙමයි. Order 2 වෙනකොට හරි. මේ වගේ graph එකක් එයි. So ether first statement එක හරි. Initial rate of the first order reaction is independent of the reaction concentration. That is incorrect. Independent, right? For the zero order and second order, that's correct. Initial rate of the first order reaction is independent of the concentration of the reactant. Yeah, independent. You know, actually, when you consider the concentration, it will change. Yeah? 49. Initial rate of the first order reaction is independent of the concentration of reactants. If you change the concentration, rate will change. So rate factor is equal to concentration factor times order. The concentration ka venas vena kota rate ka venas vena. Okay, when you change the concentration, rate will change. It's independent kiyana eka waradi. So because of that, answer is the third one. Okay. Answer is the third one. Okay, then my equation eka, rate factor is equal to concentration factor times order. If you change the concentration, rate will change. And if you change the nattika agide, zero order, ne? Zero order na concentration venas vena rate ekak venas vena ne. Then the last question, 50. Okay, so let's see the last question here. Question number 50. This one. So on a sunny day, strong photochemical smoke can be seen in the city with the heavy traffic congestion. So we know photochemical smoke, it is due to the formation of NO gas and CXH5. Okay. NO gas, CXH5, ever had another photochemical smoke again? CXH5, NO gas, and NO2. Those are the compounds. NO reacts with NO2. I think again, sir. when you consider the photochemical smoke, strong photochemical smoke can be seen in the city with heavy traffic condition. ඒක නිසා මේවා ගොඩක් traffic condition එක වැඩි වෙනකොට වාහන වල silencer වලින් above 15 Celsius it releases these gases. And then these gases can form ozone, peroxyacetal nitrate, okay? Peroxybenzyl nitrate. So when those are forming, the photochemical smoke can be obtained. The first statement is correct. And then the second one, photochemical smoke is caused entirely by scattering of solar radiation by small particles and water droplets that are emitted by vehicle exhaust systems. So the photochemical smoke is caused not by the solar radiation. Solar radiation is needed only 50 Celsius or temperature increase when known. It is caused by conversion of NO2 to ozone, okay? Hydrocarbon to peroxycidal nitrate, peroxybenzyl nitrate. Water droplets that are emitted by vehicle exhaust systems. The making answer ka hariyata explain wenne naha. So they are not explaining the answer in that part. So because of that, that's incorrect. Okay. Making answer ka hariyata explain wenne naha. E part eka baradi. So because of that, question number 50, it's answer 3. 50 wala answer ka 3 tamai apita ganna wen. 50 wala answer ka 3 kiyala gannawa. Okay. So because of that, after reaching the 50 questions, we have discussed the entire part. The rapid questions tick okkoma metana meka tikka discuss kara starting from the beginning. Clear? We mulai ina questions tika 50 wenakama discuss kara. Ida oganna meken then discussion eka balala podama men mekai karannone. Hari? Ima mama mahansela meka discuss kara. Ogala mokada karannone mekedi? Hari? Preview ekak liyanna. We have to write a preview for all the 50 MCQs. Then in this week මම මේ වීක් එකේ I'll be adding a shadow MCQ. හරි. මේකත් එක්ක දෙන shadow MCQ එකක් ඇඩ් කරනවා. Okay. So shadow MCQ එකක් ඇඩ් කරනවා you have to try that. Okay. I'll be adding only like 25 questions. You have to try all those MCQs. After writing the review. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ වගේම එකක් තමයි ඇඩ් කරන්නේ. මේ question වගේම එකක්. ඒක මේක review එක ලියලා ඒ ගන්න එකෙන් තමයි ඒ questions ටික කරන්න පුළුවන්. ඒක කරන්න ඒක තමයි මේ වීක් එකේ අපි ඒකට හෝම්වර්ක් එකක් විදියට දෙන්නේ. අපි හැම වීක් එකෙම මෙහෙමයි session එකක් දෙනවා එකෙන් හෝම්වර්ක් එකක් දෙනවා ඊට පස්සේ වීක් එකේදී ඒ session එක discuss කරනවා. මේකදී මම MCQ session එකක් තමයි හෝම්වර්ක් එකක් විදියට ඇඩ් කරන්නේ. ඔයගොල්ලෝ review එකක් තියෙන නිසා එතනදී parts දෙකක් තියෙනවා. review එකක් තියෙන නිසා parts දෙකක් එනවා MCQ review එක ලිව්වට පස්සේ. next day අපි MCQ වලින් අතර වෙන්නේ නැහැ. we'll be discussing definitely the essay part. essay එක මම discuss කරනවා. but I'll be discussing the entire essay paper 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So then plus this make a you have tried the answers for the essay paper. Then in A level exam question of whatever you win and you have tried all the answers 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Then short notes take a जो बोलो मैं इधर पास सेकंड शाय करा दिए तो हम मैं वेला लेट पहला आवत इतने ही हर सेकंड शाय के देर में वे नहीं लेकिन संभाल हर सेकंड शाय सी तो ना तीन है बी ए का सी देगा सी ए का बी वेला कितना नहीं आप बता दें अरे हम बड़ा कहे मित्र ने स्क्रीन में दिखा बताएं हम बात महान से रही दिया मेरी कहा गया ना मैं रिकॉर्डिंग ने कहती है ना हम रिकॉर्डिंग ने कह देना මේක තව ගොඩක් වෙලා ඒ රෙකෝඩින් එක ගන්න. කියන්නේ ඉරිදා වගේ පහුවේ හරි සඳර වගේ තමයි රෙකෝඩින් එක ගන්න පුළුවන්. මම ඉන්ස්ටිටියුට් එකට රෙකෝඩින් එක යවන්න නම් ඉන්ස්ටිටියුට් එකෙන් ඉල්ල ගන්න පුළුවන්. හරි. හොඳයි. එහෙනම් thank you. මම session එක ඉවර කරන්න හදන්න. හරි. අරුව